Hearing from Mr. Mehmet, it's very clear that the mission has been a success.
In 2002, Uganda passed the energy policy and followed it up with the enactment of the Atomic Energy Act in 2008 as guides for its journey of harnessing its nuclear potential. Uganda then adopted International Atomic Energy Agency's milestone-phased approach for the development of national infrastructure for nuclear power. It was this background that informed the visit of the agency's 11-member team to evaluate Uganda's readiness towards construction and operationalization of the first nuclear plant.
The locals from the possible host sites hosting, which may host the nuclear power plant, are engaged early in the program, and we even observed that participation from those locals during our interviews.
Key among the recommendations that the team made was the completion of the review process of the energy policy, which constitutes of elements in nuclear power.
This policy, once finalized and approved, will guide you how to go, where to go, and the principles of using nuclear power.
Already reviewing the policy, and this recommendation will be factored into that review. We do note your recommendation to strengthen the plans to join the relevant international legal instruments and to develop an adequate legal framework to support the nuclear power program. We will work to ensure that we are joining and we are compliant in terms of safety, security, and safeguards to support the nuclear power development and the linkage to the national legislation.
Uganda is currently on the first phase, which includes understanding commitments, obligations, and resource requirements before embarking on nuclear project. A total of 8 sites in districts of Nakasongola, Buyende, and Lamo have been identified as the possible hosts of Uganda's first nuclear electricity generation plant.
In line with your just concluded assessment of Uganda's readiness and the draft energy policy, we hope that we shall enhance the legal and institutional framework for nuclear energy to strengthen promotion and regulation of the subsector.
Story by Benon Ojambo for the news.